What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the NuVotifier Minecraft plugin with Bungeecord. NuVotifier is a great way to advertise your server and get more players to join, and using it with a server proxy like Bungeecord is super helpful in forwarding the votes to other servers as well. That being said, this isn't the easiest thing to set up, so let's jump right into it. Since this install is set up for Bungeecord, make sure to review our guide that I will have linked below on how to set up that on your proxy server. Keep in mind for the following downloads, you're going to want to put these on all of the connected servers so that Bungeecord can capture each vote and award the player. First, start by going to the spigot pages of both a NuVotifier and voting plugin and press the download now button to the right hand side, and save these both to another location, and then head over to your Apex server panel and stop the server. Enter into the FTP file access area in the top left corner, log in, and then press the plugins folder on the next page, and then press upload in the top left. Drag and drop the two jar files into the upload area, and once that reaches 100%, you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel and restart the server. One more time, don't forget you're going to have to do this on all of your servers connected to your proxy as well. Now that both of the plugins are installed, their files should be ready, so we can start with NuVotifier's configuration. Head towards your Bungeecord server and enter into the FTP file access, and then head to Plugins and the NuVotifier directory. Once you're there, you're going to want to click Edit on the config.yml file to start the configuration. And here you can make sure to change the port from 8192 to any random set of 4-digit numbers. And next, you can change the method setting to plugin messaging in the forwarding section. After that, head to your connected servers and enter into their FTP areas, and then head into plugins and Votifier and press edit on the config.yml, and then copy the token value found here. After you copy it, make sure you also set the port to -1 and the method to plugin messaging. Now you can return to your proxy's config and paste the token at the bottom of the settings where the server template is displayed. You're also going to want to make sure the corresponding server information is entered here too, like the IP and port of the server you just copied the token from. Make sure you do this for every server you want votes to be enabled on, and then you can choose to set only send to join server to true, causing players to receive votes on the server they're playing. Save and restart the server, and after that you can test a vote with your Bungeecord's NuVotifier public RSA key to see if it works, which you can find in the RSA folder of the plugins directory. If you see a similar in-game message to this after sending the vote, then the process is completed. Now we'll have to continue configuring voting plugin on all of the backend servers to make sure the rewards are properly distributed. First, start voting on all of the sites you want linked to the proxy, which will generate needed reward settings. After that, you can head towards your connected servers panel and enter into the FTP file access, log in, and then head to plugins and voting plugin. Find and press edit on the vote sites YML file and find your generated sites. And once the site is located, if you don't see a commands section below rewards, you can add it here. After that, you can enter a command using %player% to target the voter. When it's fully edited, it should resemble something like this. And then you'll want to do this process again for all of your vote sites on each backend server to complete the setup. Now, before we get into the common issues, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all of our future videos. If the voting isn't working, first start by checking you enter the correct IP and port in the proxy's NuVotifier config, and then check to make sure you properly configured the backend servers to receive the votes. For example, check that the method value is plugin messaging. If the votes are successful but rewards aren't working, make sure the exact configuration for rewards is correct. For example, any wrong spacing or placeholders can result in failed rewards. Additionally, keep in mind you don't need any slashes for the commands in the file since it's not going to read it. More votes means higher player count, and it also means rewards for the players on your server, making it a win-win situation. So make sure to get yourself started and you'll be collecting those votes in no time.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.